Spin it.
Let's begin it. Hi, and welcome back. I'm Chris.
And I'm Elisabeth.
And we're Candy Adventures.
And currently we're based out of this truck camper that's attached to our beautiful bright red Ford F-250. And today we are actually leaving that behind to go on a ride.
Yep, we're going to grab our little dual sport here, which lives on the front of our truck camper, and we're going to see if we can get onto some Western North Carolina mountain trout. I don't think so. It's August. It's late in the season, but maybe. So I'm starving. Hopefully we can get a trout for dinner. If not, we're going to have a fun adventure.
So come on with us and explore some mountain roads and some trout streams.
Okay, so we made it to our first spot, but you may be thinking, Chris, you gorilla human homunculus, how would you possibly go fishing when you're on a dual sport and we saw no gear? Well, we have a backpack and we have this right here. This is an Eagle Packaway collapsible pole, and it goes out to 6 feet,
wow.
6.5 feet in length, which is perfect for these little trout streams. As you can probably tell by my fishing jeans and my Hank Hill propane hat, that we're not Orvis fly fishing people. I do love to fly fish. I've been doing it since I was a kid, but we're not exactly gearheads about all the most expensive gear. This whole setup right here was $24.99 at Walmart, and it's been awesome. We've caught several fish on it, but we're going to get into this trout stream in our blue jeans and see, and running shoes, and see if we can catch a fish for dinner tonight.
If you're new to the channel, we've been in Guam for approximately 3 years, and we just got back about 2 months ago. Living in Guam, you don't really have much to worry about when you walk through the jungle there. There's no such thing as poison ivy or poison oak. Not a lot of things have thorns. There's no ticks, there's no chiggers, there's no venomous snakes. Well, there's one venomous snake, but they're arboreal and nocturnal. So you can kind of mindlessly tumble through the jungle and you don't really have to worry about much. And then you come back to like the southeastern US, all of these things that want to poke and sting. And there it goes.
I know a lot of guys like to wear waders when they go trout fishing, but it's one thing about me, not very good at staying dry.
All right, so I was setting up the drone and Chris just caught one. Wow.
All right, so a nice little brook trout. Look how pretty that is.
Ooh.
See his little lines on his fins? You know he's a brook trout? Very pretty.
So I was just setting up the drone to try to show this beautiful stream, and I didn't even get the drone set up yet. Probably like what, fifth, sixth cast or something?
Oh yeah.
And hit it.
Hit our little single hook Panther Martin on our $24 Walmart rod, and we're going to take this guy back for dinner in a Ziploc bag. So we're going to keep fishing and
exploring.
Hopefully we can get on some more.
Yeah.
Bought a Coke and some gasoline, and I drove out to the county fair.
We've fished this little stretch, and I think we're gonna go on to the next one. Chris has been carrying the channel with a majority of the fish catching cooks, and I'd really like to catch at least one trout in North Carolina because I've never done it before. So fingers crossed.
When I saw her for the first time, she was standing there in the second line. And it all started.
We've found another pretty spot where we could actually drive the dual sport right up to the riverbank. And this is where I'm going to try my luck, this small stretch right here. Come on, let's see how it goes.
I had a barbecue sale on my white t-shirt. She was killing me in that mini skirt. Skipping rocks on the river by the road.
Nothing in this stretch so we're gonna go back to the bike and ride around some more. If there's not another spot, we'll at least get a pretty view along this river. Let's go. Jungle, it's just the type of plants changed. Okay.
All right, this is location number 3. Hopefully Elisabeth can get on her trout so that we can both have a trout to take back and cook over a fire.
It's because Chris doesn't want to share a tiny trout for dinner. He wants me to provide for my own. This is why I'm not holding the camera gear. Bathing suit on,
because
it's bound to happen.
All right, first mountain trout. Keep tension on it. Keep tension, get it up to the bank. All right, first mountain trout. Woo, that's a big one too.
It's a fetish.
Woo. Woo, look at that. All
oh,
right.
Oh, so slimy. Oh my God, it's a rainbow, right?
Yeah.
I wasn't even sure if there was a fish on because I keep hitting rocks and I haven't really learned the difference between the fish, you know, hitting it or it hitting a rock, and it's been a rock for about 2 hours, so the fish was a nice surprise.
All right, what a pretty little rainbow.
It's very slippery.
That's why I knocked the fish out with a pocket knife, because of the, there's some clumsiness on this channel. But all right.
It's one-sided clumsiness I'm responsible. But, first one! Not a bad day at all. That is a wing of a, like a cicada, I think. And a lot of worms. And a piece of corn.
So it's stolen somebody's bait.
Yeah, it has nabbed somebody's stuff today. Want some trout roe?
We could feed that trout roe to these little trout fry in this pool.
Tear it up.
All right, so that's not a super Disney-fied circle of life, but trout are in fact cannibals. It's kind of the circle of life, just not the Disney-fied one. This is the more realistic circle of life here, feeding these fry. Okay, so we don't, we never catch a full limit of fish or anything. Well, we probably couldn't catch a full limit of fish, to be honest, but we never keep more than what we're gonna eat that day. So this is gonna be enough. These two trout, especially this one's a little larger, will be enough for what we're gonna fix tonight. So we're gonna hop back on the dual sport and head back to the cabin that we get to stay in. We're gonna put a fire on and cook these things over a fire.
Yeah, and enjoy the ride back. Let's go for a ride.
All right, so we took a quick break from fishing, from successful fishing, to we figured we're in the area to take the motorcycle up on its first elevation.
So we took some paved and gravel roads and a lot of switchbacks to get as much elevation as we could in this area for this view of the Blue Ridge Mountains.
You might as well ask me to describe the glory of the Great Smoky Mountains as they rise from the mist of a Carolina dawn.
So super pretty down there. The National Forest is super pretty. The only thing is we've gained a couple thousand feet in elevation, And so the bikini top went away because with that, the temperature dropped. So I'm going to go ahead and get down a little bit lower towards the lake where we can get the bikini top back out. Oh, on film, we're the worst helmet takeoff of all time. Looks super cool. Looks like a Lorenzo Lamas.
I was wondering what was happening.
I got my hair stuck on this.
Oh, is that what you were messing with when you were riding?
Yeah.
Oh.
All right, so we're back to our cabin. Not our cabin, but the cabin we're staying in for the next few days. Let's go cook a trout.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, you're so fast. Bean, Bean, Bean. Hey, sit, sit. Guess what? While the fire's going, getting heated up, ready to put the fish on, we're going to try something other than Velveeta cheese. We are going to try to make our own sauce from scratch, inspired by Sheets Dr. Pepper sauce, which is delicious, and Sheets is arguably one of the best gas stations that we happen to stop by all the time. But we don't have Dr. Pepper, so we're going to be using Coca-Cola. Spin it. It looks like our sauce is simmered down and a saucy consistency. It's as close to this Dr. Pepper barbecue sauce as we can get. We're pretty limited on ingredients between what this cabin has and what we have in our little truck camper, but I think it's close enough to still be delicious.
Do you think this sauce is simmered down now or simmered down now?
Well, I'd like to invite you to simmer down now!
Simmer down now.
Okay, that's good. So, as rock bottoming things do, and we're somewhere that we don't own, the back of the chiminea here just fell apart. There's a big crack in it, but it currently just opened up as a pass-through, so now people on the other side can enjoy it too. So this will be fun in explaining to the owners of this place.
Rock bottoming! You're rock bottoming!
I am. Anyway, what do you expect? Pretty meat, look at that.
Ooh.
Pretty little rainbow.
Mmm, sweet.
It's good.
It's like sweet salmon.
Mmm. Yeah, very good. It's like a glaze on a salmon.
Mm-hmm.
Very good.
Well, we appreciate you guys tuning in for this episode. It was a pretty successful fishing experience for our channel.
I just have fun anytime we can get out on a dual sport and play around in the mountains and a river. So, see you guys next time. Thanks for sticking around. And we'll see you next week, wherever in the world that might be. Probably here again, but maybe somewhere else. Who knows? So, thanks for sticking around.